Thank you. Please stand. I am resurrection and I am life, says the Lord. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall not die forever. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awaking, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him, who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord, and if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who by the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light, grant that your servant Mary Elizabeth, being raised with him, may know the strength of his presence and rejoice in his eternal glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, deal graciously with us in our grief. Surround us with your love, that we may not be overwhelmed by our loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from Lamentations. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. For the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he does not willingly afflict or grieve anyone. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read together Psalm 121 as found in your bulletin. I lift up my eyes to the hills, from whence is my help to come. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved, and he who watches over you will not fall asleep. Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe. The Lord shall watch over your going out and your coming in, from this time forth forevermore. A reading from the book of Revelation. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of the Lord.
Please stand as we turn to page 400 in the hymnal, the blue hymnal in your pew, as we sing together "All Creation, Creatures of Our God and King."
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away, for I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Thank you for being here. Thank you for coming and surrounding us and helping us to get through this very difficult time. Thank you for your support and your love for Mary Beth and her family. We are here to remember and honor Dr. Mary Elizabeth Kunkel, Mary Beth, Beth. She was our friend, mentor, teacher, sister, aunt. And she was the most indomitable fountain of energy and knowledge I've ever seen in such a tiny package. We love her and we miss her. It is hard to say goodbye. But we have, for now, and are here for consolation and hope. As we place her ashes here, in the place that was her heart's home for the last decades of her life on this earth. And our consolation comes to us partly in being gathered with others who loved Mary Beth. We draw comfort from being near to each other and sharing memories and stories, and I hope that there will be lots of that in just a little while when we gather together in the parish hall. We all know and love Beth from a variety of ways in which she expressed her hope, which was grounded in Christ's love for her and her love for him. I know Mary Beth through her prodigious outpouring of that hope and her love for Holy Trinity, serving in the background of so much of the life of this parish. And I almost wrote that she served quietly in the background, but we all know that Beth spoke her mind freely, sometimes sharply, but always with the purpose of making something better. Because that was the way that Beth expressed her faith, trying her best to work with God to make the world a better place. Our hope today comes from the gospel that Beth embraced in her own unique way. She was quite the interpreter of scripture and its messages. Today we heard, "All who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up." Beth has seen the Son. I know this because we've talked about it. And she has interpreted his grace through her unique lens of scientific inquiry and has accepted that raised up resurrection life with practical application. Beth's love for God she experienced most keenly, I think, in the natural world, in its patterns of growth and giving, dying and rising to new life with the cycle of the seasons. And Beth brought that insight to our weekly Bible study. We would be talking about the work of the Holy Spirit, and she would make a connection for us with the ways in which protein chains interact with each other.
And we'd all be going, whoa, what was that? She opened up my liberal arts brain to new ways of thinking about the words on the page and the word made flesh. And I miss her perspective. Beth expressed the hope that she found in God's creation through her love of gardening and teaching. Many of us are here, at least in part, to honor the rich legacy of Beth's teaching, either in formal settings of classroom or professional associations, or in the church kitchen, as she taught us how to can and preserve and batch things up according to the traditional folkways that she learned in Arkansas on that farm. Some of us are here to celebrate that finest friendship category of all, garden friends. There are none better. And Beth was our garden friend. Linda and Charlie remember their sister's staunch determination to do everything the right way, her way. All of us have been touched by Mary Beth's love for the simple and pure in a complicated world. Beth's expression of God's love in the world was like no other I've ever seen. And our consolation in the face of the loss of that is that love never ends. Love has gathered Beth more closely to God's most tender care and presence. And that same love invites us to draw near and to believe, to interpret and accept eternity life in our own ways. And whatever lenses we peer through to see the light of love, we can be drawn by that path to the same heart that holds Beth now. And every time we draw near to God, we also draw near to those whom we love but see no more with the eyes of our mortal bodies. The resurrection life available through Christ is visible throughout all creation. And Beth helped me to see that in new ways, for which I'm faithful. I look for my friend, Beth, with the eyes of faith in the eternal Word through whom all things were made. I know her hope of the healing of creation was central to her understanding of Christ's salvation for the whole world. And I can think of no finer tribute for Mary Beth than to share in her dream of creation healed and doing all that we can to share in God's work toward that end. That gives me hope for this life and the next. I hope the same is true for you, and that you find comfort for your sorrowing hearts in the divine love that surrounds us today. It brought out the sunlight for us and for Mary Beth. Please stand. And in the assurance of eternal life given at baptism, let us proclaim our faith and say,
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered.
Thank you. Let us pray to God, our Creator, saying, Lord, have mercy. Loving God, you have called your people together in the mystical body of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die daily to sin and rise to newness of life, and that we, with our Redeemer, may pass through the grave and gate of death to our joyful resurrection.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant to us who are still on our earthly pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sin and serve you with a quiet mind.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant that Beth, increasing in the knowledge and love of you, may go from strength to strength in a new life of perfect peace.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant to us and all who mourn a sure confidence in your tender mercy, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love.
Lord, have mercy.
Give courage to all who are bereaved, that in the days ahead they may hold fast to the comfort of a holy hope and joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. Help us and trust Beth to your never-failing care and love. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, and remember her according to the favor you bear for your people.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated as we prepare to continue with Holy Communion. And just a word or two about that. Everyone is welcome to approach the Lord's table here. You can come forward and receive the bread and the wine. The way that we are doing this here is we will intink the wafer for you and place it on your hand if you wish to receive. If you do not wish to receive, you can cross your hands across your chest and either John or I will offer a blessing for you in the name of the Trinity. And let's see, seems like there was something else I was meant to say. At the final hymn, if you would please fall in behind the family, and we are all going to process out to the garden for the committal. All of those who wish to attend may do so. And so just as we come by, fall in behind us, and we will make our way to do that final part outside. See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them, and they will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who will forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself, in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen." Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Jesus Christ.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth we shall return. For so you did ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Mary Beth. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the mercies, into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. May the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.